Teclistamab is a BCMA CD3 bispecific T-cell engager. BCMA is highly expressed on myeloma cells and has limited expression on normal tissue, making it an ideal target for anti-myeloma strategies. MajesTEC was a phase I first-in-human study studying teclistamab in patients with relapsed refractory myeloma. It identified the recommended phase II dose, which was a weekly subcutaneous dosing of 1,500 micrograms per kilo, with step-up doses of 60 micrograms per kilo and 300 micrograms per kilo. The MajesTEC trial was for patients with relapsed disease. Of note, patients could not have had prior anti-BCMA therapy. As I mentioned, the identified dose, 1,500 micrograms per kilo sub-Q weekly. This was a group of heavily pretreated patients with a median of 5 prior lines of therapy. 36% at the recommended phase II dose were pentadrug refractory, 83% were triple-class refractory. We found that teclistamab was well tolerated. Cytopenias were generally mild and confined to the step-up dosing into cycles 1 and cycle 2. There was one episode of neurotoxicity, also mild grade 1 tremor in a patient, and it resolved without any intervention. The injection site reactions also mild and treated with symptomatic therapy such as topical steroids. We saw CRS in 70% of the patients, and all CRS events were grade 1 and grade 2. Median onset to CRS was 2 days. Median duration of the CRS was also 2 days. In this group of heavily pretreated patients, we found a very encouraging response rate. At the recommended phase II dose, the response rate was 65%. And also we found that responses were deep, with 58% of patients achieving a VGPR and 40% achieving a complete response or better. Responses were also rapid. Median time to first response was 1 month. And in a subgroup of patients, we also found MRD negative responses. In regards to durability of responses, follow-up is still relatively short, but the responses appear durable and to deepen over time. 85% of the responders after a median follow-up of 7.1 months are alive and continuing on therapy. We also have more data on the IV cohorts with longer follow-up, and there, after a median follow-up of 15.6 months, 59% of the responders remain on therapy. The PK and PD data also support this dosing schedule and show high exposure at this level, as well as evidence of consistent T cell activation. And this dose is now being evaluated in an open label phase II expansion study.